We'll run out of seating here, so we're going to take when the little people come. Between that seating and this first portion will be for us. Yeah, I'm kind of taking.
You would never think. produced by Charles Pierce. While I wouldn't dare refer to our beloved friend as a drag queen, if he was standing in front of me, I would refer to him as a control queen. During our last visit, which was a few weeks ago, he was on his deathbed, literally, strewn with sheet music, barely able to get his voice into a whisper, but authoritatively giving me directions on who would speak and what precisely they would say, what songs would be played, and who would play them. At this point, I'd like to introduce our harpist, Lori Andrews. The songs she played were some of Charles's favorites. Shall We Gather at the River, Smiling Through, Look for the Silver Lining, Right as the Rain, and Would You? Before I introduce our first speaker, I would like to acknowledge the generosity of someone who I know we are all grateful for. Everyone in this room, I know, rests somewhat more happily and joyously knowing that Charles was well taken care of during the last few months of his life. And this is, as we all know, a grueling, somewhat thankless task. But we can all rest assured that he was, and I saw it happen with my own eyes, he was cared for until the final moment with incredible love and unselfishness and generosity. And the person who did that was Donald Copas. We're all
under his autumnal frost shall be as any leaf, be no less dead than the first leaf that fell. Your wonder fled, altered, estranged, disintegrated, lost. Nor shall our love avail you in your hour. In spite of all our love, you will arise upon that day and wander down the air as obscurely as an unattended flower, it mattering not how beautiful you were or how beloved above all else that dies. Edna St. Vincent Millay. And now it's my pleasure to introduce Jackie Altea.
In his own words. here's what he says. As I reflect back on my life and my lifestyle, I realize what a joyous and happy time most of it was. There was my work, which was really a play. I had my mother, aunt, father, other relatives, and friends who were like family. I was always on the move. My life was enhanced by a fair amount of good health and a loving family. Jessie, my mother, was the one person I really wanted to be with. Also, my aunt Carolyn was a terribly important person in my life. My father, at times distant, was still a wonderfully understanding man, and I know he loved me. He passed away from asthma in 1973. During the nightclub years, I would finish an engagement, return to my apartment, get things in order, and then fly off to Watertown, New York, to be with mother and dad. I must have made the trip from the Syracuse airport by car 300 times. Watertown was always beckoning. When Dad died and Mother was alone, I made the trip more often. Then, like a ballet dancer, I knew my time was up and I should leave the clubs. Mother had died the year before, and I had not fully recovered from her death. I retired the act in October of 1990. Mother died in 1989, and Aunt Carolyn in 1995. She was my support after Mother passed away. Since Mother's death and my departure from the world of nightclubs, life has been totally different. I had a few good retirement years after 1990, with trips to Europe and elsewhere. When Aunt Carolyn took ill in January of 1995, I made trips to Watertown to see about her upkeep. She had nurses and caregivers round the clock till July, when she too left my life. I was left her Victorian-style house and a substantial amount of money. Sadly, I had to sell the house, as I could not live there alone. I left the house for the last time in the fall of 95, and a dear friend, Charlie Bill Dunham, took over the sale of the contents of the house. Charlie himself died a few years ago. I have a list of over 100 friends who have died. All missed so much. Now, as they say, it's your turn. In February of 1997, I was diagnosed with prostate cancer. Those of you who know that I love a vodka martini. Perhaps they did me in while I was doing them. It is not true. I am to be cremated and my ashes with some glitter dust be put in an empty Smirnoff bottle and tossed off the Golden Gate Bridge. What an exit. Perhaps too splashy. I have had my share of good times, and certainly more laughs than are allowed. Some may not think this was right, but it was right for me. So, to my endearing and enduring friends and relatives, as eternity beckons, I leave you all with these thoughts. Laugh sun shine warm upon your face, and rains fall soft upon your fields. And until we meet again, may God hold you in the hollow of his hand. That's all.
A man may kiss a maid goodbye, the sun may kiss the butterfly, the morning dew may kiss the grass, and you, my friend,
thank you.
those that would like to go to the gravesite are welcome to go. You are not obligated to go. If you will please remain seated until I have ushered you forward. Thank you for your attendance today.
Still ahead and call him. He's just last